Fuck special weapon block. Fuck warp field. Sighted heart made out of units. Oh, you get experience even if you don't kill an enemy, as long as you hit them. So I've got two characters I've hit him with so far, they both leveled up.
Just because they hit him.
Yeah, just because they hit him. It's pretty fun. It's pretty funny that way. Gonna be the last total receipt. We're not using Claymore Overlord to follow this up. We're going to use Plasma Horn. It's free. She has SP regenerate, so yeah, she's got one of the best. It costs 10, and she's gonna regenerate 10 SP in the next turn. So, you know. There's no, literally no reason not to do that.
Ah. No matter who it is, if it's the boss, they level up.
Seriously. Alright, now. See, she's gonna be a bit of a rough one. See that hunt? Oh, she's got SP regenerate and alert, so actually it's not. It's not at all. I don't know what I'm talking about. Schwing. Wait, she does have SP regeneration. Okay. That's one of those things where it's just like, okay, no, it's fine. It's fine, it's fine. Split missile better. Oh yeah, use herbs on her, because then you'll just waste 30 energy, and that's great. Holy god.
He's so strong that you level up no matter what.
Yeah. Oh, I should have given her a fucking... a better weapon. Oh, can shoot the plot reach? Thank you! Shoot the plot reach. Okay. His willpower started at like 119. He's only got one of those, and once he's used that, he can only either do his melee attack or his ultimate. I hate it. All of this guy's attacks use energy. And I really wish they either didn't, or that the unit had, like, built-in energy recharge. That would have been nice. Can't even scum that out. Fuck. That would get rid of just... I mean, that's... Yeah, he does. Literally his first one. So, random spike. Weapon. Oh, there's two, yeah. Because this thing transforms between two modes, it has two pilots. Well, not because of that, but it has two pilots. So right. They both get experience when combat act occurs.
He definitely drops trying to defend against you.
Oh, fuck me. He doesn't have... Shit. Oh, and he'll steady. That's rough. And I don't want to attack him until what the hell? Oh no. Okay. Does she? She does. Yeah. Does she? She does. And, yes. Okay. Whole first row of weapons. All out of ammo. So all he can do is Elegantom and Herbsun. I want him to do Herbsun. Actually, I might move everyone again and try to do the whole not surrounding him thing. Not perfectly surrounding him, because now that he doesn't have a move he can use after moving, the AI might react differently. I am hoping...
It's worth it to try.
yeah, it's worth it to try. I'm hoping the AI will react differently. Damn, that 15%. Come on, really?
Wow.
Daff 14,000 damage.
Yeah.
Still, that actually took out more energy than I was expecting
to. Yeah.
So, that wasn't too bad. It's just a shame there's no way I can, well, it's not possible that I could use love, but I'm not gonna do that. The point I'm about to make here is I'm not gonna do that. Especially when she's got renewal. That is much more.
100.
I really wish I'd gotten Kim Esperita, right, honestly. Okay. And oops, pay attention. 239 energy. When it comes his turn, check the number again. That's it. We got that first dodge. Double image, yo! Double image for days! What'd I just say? Fucking double image for days! It's not even dodging, she's just flickering through everything. There we go. So the Super War game I'm going to go to after this one, I'm near the end of it already. I've heard, people on forums seem to agree that it's one of the easier SRW games. So I'm hoping that we'll get through it fairly swiftly. You get so many ludicrous fucking max amount too, but I'm not surprised. Alright. He went from 239, did I say? 434.
Damn. Almost a whole 200,
actually. Yeah, attack back with that assault blade. Because he's gonna miss. That was 30, and there's another 10, so I just took off 40 again.
Game 195. Jesus.
Oh. Yep, and now we need to repeat that process. I'm so cramped in because of all the enemies. Whatever. start draining more energy. Burning dagger. I actually really like the burning dagger books. Oh, you're not standing next to somebody who has. That's annoying. Alright, fine. Here you go. Over here. We're not using it yet. Hell, you're actually gonna use Weapon Breaker because I don't care. I just need something that hits his barrier. That's all. Wait, what?
At full health?
He heals, too.
Oh, shit.
He has health regen small and energy regen large.
Okay.
Yeah. Now I'm just like, why did the... I'm just super confused about why that didn't get a barrier. No, it just said hit. If it hits the barrier, it'll actually say barrier.
Ah.
And you know it doesn't matter. We use Astaline. First railgun. See, hit barrier.
Yeah.
Offensive support. Hit barrier. See, it's alright. We're doing things. We're getting there. That has 0% chance to hit. It's fucking beautiful is what it is. Man, keep using Herb Sun! Do it, because if two people hit him and he uses that, it's 50 energy. You know? Like, do it! Do it! Come on!
Do it!
6%. Please tell me she's got good. She's got alert. She's got life alert. She's fine. She's fine. We're gonna go with those anti-air missiles though. Dang, another Herb Sun that doesn't hit. That was... Which Schwarzenegger movie was that? Come on, you piece of shit, do it!
I don't remember.
Because he's trying to lure him into a trap.
Yeah.
Do it!
It was, oh my god, the first Predator, wasn't it?
I feel like
that's
it
was the only
something
one
else.
I can think of that he taunts something into trying to do something.
No, he totally does it in, Commando? One of the earlier movies. I could have sworn it was the one where he kills the dude by throwing like the pipe into him and he gets stuck in a gas pipe, a steam pipe.
Oh, and it
and he's like
steams out the blood or whatever.
Well, yeah, but then he says the stupid one-liner about like why don't you vent off or something, like I don't remember what it said. It's like one of his
steam.
Yeah, or something like that. It's one of his like cheese balliest one-liners of all time. It's pretty amazing. It's the one that like everybody loves to use as well. I think the like come on, do it is from that movie because he was like he was trying to goad the guy into coming at him and he had like a trap laid down. Because he didn't talk much to the Predator.
Except for during that final fight, where he's trying to...
And even then, they didn't really talk that much. And no, during the final fight, when they were, like... You mean when they were actually, like, fighting each other?
Yeah.
Yeah, they...
It was just before that that I thought he said that.
I don't know. It's been... it's been so long. And I never saw the other movie, the one where he steam pipes the guy. I never actually saw that. As, like, ever.
I think that one was Commando.
144 energy.
Jesus.
We're getting them down. This is making me burp. God damn it. This is working. My point is, this is working. Alright. 9. Vulcan. Keep using Herb Sun. I love you. Do it. Do it. Over and over and over, and lose all your fucking energy. Like, he's actually losing energy faster because of that attack than the last incarnation of him. Because 30 is such a bigger number than 10. It's literally three times the number 10 is. So this has been, this is going alright. This is working. The plan, oh, I shouldn't have used that for that. Oh, well, whatever. We can use him for that. Oh, right. Against all. Oh, what was the percentage? 25. I just got off. Yes. Okay. 20 energy. God. Russell's Prevail level 9. You could deck. Like, Russell. It's weird. His defense stat isn't high enough. But if you dumped stuff into his defense stat and gave him, like, guard shit, he could be, like, one of the tankiest motherfuckers in the whole series. He could be better than Kai. Let's do this. He's at 74. You. Alert. Smasher. Super plot. Shoulder plot. Herb Sun. Good. Good. This is good. Give his offensive support and hits the barrier. He has 24 energy.
Jesus, so he can't do another Herb
Sun. He can't even attack back at this point. So I still need to hit him with attack follow up. So we'll do. Look at that. All dashes, because he can't attack me with anything. So there's literally just no attack. So we'll do this, and split
so everybody
missile.
That's left can attack him freely.
After this, yep. Because now, no more barrier. That was the last of his energy for the barrier. He has literally 4 energy. Everyone else here can now start doing actual damage.
Damn.
Okay.
Now that you can actually whittle his health down.
Yeah. Okay, saving. Here we go. And now I'm going to start playing battle animations. So, Valor, which doubles damage. Royal Heartbreaker, followed up by Claymore Overlord. Yes. This is why he's actually in position 1 right there. Go! It's too bad we're not hearing their normal music because it fits the attack better. Because their attack is them, like, dancing while they attack him. The fucking, the PS, like, 4 version of this attack animation is amazing. They actually appear, like, on a stage in front of a crowd and beat up the enemy on that stage while dancing and shit. And they transform from their pilot uniforms into, like, pop idol Lolita outfits. It's really funny. Which was that? 19,000. That's a lot more damage than I was expecting. I wonder if his defense just isn't as good as his last incarnation. Oh, this attack's fucking cool. Because it uses every single weapon he's got. And yeah, you kind of have to just accept the fact that scale's fucked in these games. Mm-hmm. So mechs that are supposed to be, like, that dude, like I said, he's supposed to be the size of a small beef. Whereas the Altaisan there is the size of a beefy Gundam. 10,000. Nope. Actually, you'll get used for a different. Oh, this is annoying. Nah, whatever. We'll deal with it. Here it is. I'm kind of curious how much damage Elgin Tom will actually do.
You want
to say first and find out, or?
It may actually be meaningful. I'm just gonna test it. I don't even care about the. 5,000. I need to stop it. That leaves him pretty fucking
near death.
Yeah, I'm just like, it's not. Faith fully replenishes an ally's HP. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and
do it.
No. Yeah, we're gonna let him get hit and then. Yeah. Because if I don't use. If I only use one alert over the next 3 turns, I'd actually get 3 turns of valor. And I'm probably gonna need it. So conserving on my SP is important here. Oh no, he's got SP regenerate, so it's even. I might even get more uses of it out of that. Okay, that's fine. We're gonna do it like this. Also, this fucking attack is awesome. Can she not? Oh, her fucking willpower's! Crap. And that's a 3-9? Is she too close? She's literally too close. That's annoying. And there's no one else around him that you're supporting. Oh, that's super annoying. Whatever, we're just gonna have to fucking deal with it. Oh, shit, is he a valor up yet? I'm just like terrified of everything right now. Check this shit out. Fucking Rampage Ghost. It's such a great name, too. Goodbye kiss. So, goodbye. And they just fucking unload.
Damn. Joker card.
How much? 30,000. If there is fate, then this is also fate. I forgot what that looked like. That was cool. Good call, but the bets are still on the table. That's a shame. I didn't put her willpower up so she can make a little attack. So she's not going to be doing much damage. But every little bit helps. And hey, it's a two-person attack. Each person has a turn, so I'm going to use Rampage Ghost twice. Oh yeah, and we're following that shit up with some Tyrant Breaker. Hey, we got the other dialogue, I think. Yep, they have two different dialogues for this attack. I love it. There was only one dialogue for this attack in the first game. In the second, in this game, before their mechs got upgraded, they had a different animation for this attack. And they had two different dialogues for it, I think. One of the running gags is going to come up here at the end of this dialogue. Because Kyosuke's ultimate attack in the first game is called Trunk Run. And he always calls his ultimate attack that. She always wants to call it their love power. But she always stops to call it and calls it the proper Joker card or whatever.
22, almost 23,000.
In one of the later games, one of the dialogues, she starts to call it their Joker card and goes, ah, screw it, it's our love power. I fucking love it. In one of them, she actually calls the name of the attack, but she doesn't say Rampage Ghost. She calls it our Ghost Chant of Rampage. Yeah, it was really... those two are fucking hilarious together. You... actually... love... I'm 20. Not only are combo attacks very powerful, I've been dumping all my money into them. So, everyone else isn't going to do quite as much damage. Fucking love this mech! Fucking kick everything! Kick everyone's butt to oblivion! Oh, time for... No! He's not fucking close enough? Oh, shit. Oh. Fuck.
Is there a way to move somebody out of the way and put him closer?
I'm gonna have to.
And then still have that person you move attack?
His Tornado Blade has a greater range than his version of Tornado Blade. Actually, I do know why, I think. No, I don't know why. Shit. It was what, 1-3? So it's literally one fucking range too short right now. Shit. So the best... Unfortunately, the best way to do this is going to mean having to omit some... at least one offensive support. We got 2-3-0-2. Okay, so you can use both of yours, so... You're gonna go... You're gonna... You know what? That's fine. You're gonna go... Here. No, you're not! Shit! Because guess what? Kicks only 2 range. Fuck! I'm gonna have to move him, aren't I? Unless I move her. I'll just move her. But I want to use... okay, we're gonna... Oh. See ya, Samsara. Actually, how much energy is missing from this total right there?
70.
Yeah, so 35. Okay. So you know what? There, they can move again. You're gonna go there. You're gonna... Ow. Balls. Flip. Oh no, actually it's fine. That's actually fine. No, it's fine. Valor. So when he was the follow-up attack, he did like 9,000 damage and change. Here's what happens with Valor as the front runner. 24,000. That wasn't even a combo attack. That's just him.
Damn.
That's just him in the fucking Gatsby kick maxed out. I maxed out the money on the Gatsby kick, and I give him in fight plus 8. And he comes standard with attacker, which is what I mentioned before. Will's over 130. Times 1.2 on the damage. In fight plus 8, in fight increases melee damage. Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, exactly. Alright.
All There's right. no way that boss has enough regen power to go back to full health now.
No, not even. Not even close. Oh, you shitbag. Now he's using it to chain one? Hey. Fuck. She has hit in a way I live gagging to death. 6. Wants me to start the drop, of course, because that's going to be a lot of Colossal Burst, which is a enough on him to use on the way down. Oh, did I have her? Valor. That would have been a wasted attack. She goes there, and now he can move down here and do tornado blade. Valor. Okay, that's $31,000. I'm in trouble. No, wait, you're in trouble. dodged it, so. Oh, no, wait, he has... No, but he has still... This attack, so. I'm gonna go ahead and see. This take, like I said, this takes long enough as is. So, something I should note. It seems like the overall damage values are dropping slowly. They are. That's because he has Prevail. Level 9, which is the max level. Prevail is as your HP decreases. Your armor, chance to crit, chance to hit, and something else all go up in relation to how much, you know, where your health
is. Of course, his chain attack is max.
Yeah, that's not really an issue. But then he also has guard, which is an attacker, which are at 130 plus will. The attacker is the one times 1.2 damage boost, and the guard is a... It doesn't specify what the defense boost is, but it's there. And then revenge is that he gets a 1.2 times damage boost when he's counterattacking. And his ace bonus is that he gets a 20% boost to all his damage dealt. I have no idea what CT 4 means. Like, I think it means CT correction, but I don't know what CT means. I've never learned what that meant. Let's see, I turn that right here in this range. And chain attack. Let's save and disable. Alert. Wow. Yeah, that doesn't prevent it from changing through the other two.
What does the 0% mean now?
The 0%. It just means that he has a 0% chance to hit the dude who's attacking him. So he has a 0% chance to hit forward. But he still has a chance to hit them.
Is it possible that you could miss them both when you do that attack?
I think Loon could dodge it, but I don't think Arado can. Let's see what happens. I save. You know what? We'll take it, because Arado is in tank the match. Barely, but...
Yeah. Healing that.
Good. I've got one more use of faith. This'll do me. Yeah, that's the problem. He's gonna chain through and hit Kai. Now, Kai's pretty tanky, so I don't know that he's actually going to kill him, but... No, I already bowed up. We'll deal with it this time, so we'll see what happens.
The freakish luck you get.
.421. That was so little damage. Nice. Okay. Look how much fucking damage we did.
Yeah.
I was not expecting that. Alright.
Can you heal that one guy before the end of your turn, or?
I don't think so. I can do this. I can. So yes, I lied. Yes, I can.
Most of it back.
Yep. We'll leave it like that. That's fine. Because even if he takes another hit, it's not going to be an issue at all. Save. Immediately save again. I should note that this, like, the stage theme that started playing here, as opposed to the boss's theme during the attack animations, this is the game's main theme. Huh. And this is the only time in the game you'll hear it off the title screen. I love when games use their fucking, like, main theme as well.
And this is the final boss of the game?
Yep, this is the true final boss. We beat this guy, and we have beaten Super Robot Wars Original Generation 2. And I'm hoping he attacks Latuni again. Because he'll miss, for starters. It'll be Herbsund, which is 30 energy, and I'll have her hit him back with anything for 10 more energy. Which will be, you know, getting us along, and because we have to redo the energy that he, you know, we have to re-get rid of the energy that he regenerates.
Mm-hmm. So he was at 4 energy?
Yeah.
He'll probably regen another 195 like he did last time.
Yeah. If we can get him to keep...
to 199.
Yeah. If we can get him to keep wasting 50 because of using Herbsung and getting hit by 2 people, that means we can attack with literally like 2 people and get rid of all the energy, and get rid of almost all the energy. Like, so 3 people attacking should theoretically get rid of all of his energy. Four people, something like that. A small enough number, like my supports will do the attacks, and then all my attackers will be free. There we go. Yes. I sing it. Sing it true. Use that fucking double image, right? There we go. See? It's all good when you use the double image. It's fucking spectacular. Wonderful. I love it. Yes. Yes. Fucking Soul Blade. Yeah. He went to 199. You were completely accurate with the numbers. And see, he doesn't get that much health back.
Yeah.
Because he only gets 10%, as opposed to the 30% of his energy. Again, 30 is a bigger number than 10. It's 3 times the number 10 is.
Yep.
Double image, smack. Those double images all over the fucking place. It's wonderful. Fucking beautiful. Which puts him at 159 when my turn starts. So yeah, 3 people attacking should hack this
stop
out.
From
yeah.
Anything else.
Let's do... Yeah, let's do this. I've got my plan. I've got my spine. I've got my orange crush. We're actually going to watch this because I love the way that it looks. And hey, might as well watch another one of those giant lasers miss. I don't know. I really love the way those missiles look when they fire. Don't really get why they're called burning dagger, but whatever. It looks cool. Miss! Is this all you can do? You might notice she just has a red version of that one dude's mech, but it was blue. This red version is a secret mech. It sucks though. In the story playthrough, you actually get to see and use a red version of the other one. the one that the girl was piloting of the two bird mechs. But you can never get that one. Which is just such a crying shame. One more attack with backup, and then we can lay into him. Like, super hard. Actually... That was... not what I meant to do. Whatever. The Graviton Cannon is the weapon I unlocked in Stage 15 that made it, like, possible to beat the bosses earlier than I was supposed to.
Yeah.
Oh, God damn it, lady. You're just gonna use everything. I don't even give a shit. Graviton Cannon. It's gonna do jack shit damage. That's the thing that's annoying.
94% chance to 0% damage.
What?
Nothing. Oh, that's for your hit, isn't it?
Yeah, that's mine.
Okay.
But we get to see what Graviton Cannon looks like. It's a giant gun, and it shoots a giant gravity bullet. It goes blah. I love it. Nope.
Off to the head, sorry.
Throw that shield! Wow! That's fine. You're out of energy, sir! And I've got pretty much everybody ready to go. Fuck. I'm just like, yes! We are there!
This final boss... it can say good night in however many languages it can manage to spit out the word good night before he dies.
Valor. Guess we kick. Play more Overlord. Let's do it.
50,000. That'd be crazy.
God, I would. I don't know. I've seen some SRW games. You would get some dumbass fucking damage calculations up in there.
24 though.
And again, not even a combo attack, just him by himself. That's what I did with that unit. I said, fuck the world. This guy is one of my absolute favorites, and I love that mech. It's funny because the mech he's using, it's just a secret version of a mass-produced mech. I actually have like four or five or six of the mass-produced versions.
Okay.
I mean, some of them are more specialized than others, but the Guest Vents, which is what the name of mech is, it's an outdated even, like in the lore of the universe, at the point that the games happen, the Guest Vents is an outdated unit. It's been replaced by other units in mass production.
Huh.
And it's one of my absolute favorites. I love them. I love the Guest Vents to death. That's not what I want. Whatever. Alert. Valor. Does he even need strike? What do you mean he needs three more? Fuck you, sir. I can't believe that. I can't believe he's not at 140. Son of a bitch. Fuck it, I guess we'll use a Akashic Buster. I feel pretty confident in saying this guy is not going to survive this fucking turn. So this is not his ultimate attack. I was hoping to use Cosmo Nova, which is his ultimate attack. This is Akashic Buster. And also, you haven't gotten to see this mech yet, so...
creates a phoenix, essentially, out of his attack.
Yeah, his mech is literally magic.
Huh.
I love how fucking beefy the ball sock laser looks.
Yeah.
He's all, do not struggle, and I'm like, dude, have you looked at your health bar?
Struggling.
Yeah, like, you're the one who's got a problem right now.
If you prefer to eat giant lasers.
Strike. Royal Heartbreaker. Anti-air missile. That's a good point. I forgot that that was Russell next to her. So we're gonna follow up this big flashy combo attack with just a couple missiles. It's not even that the mech he's in doesn't have a better attack, it does, but because he's one of my supports, I don't bother with his willpower. So he doesn't have his willpower up high enough to actually do the gravity impact cannon that the jet he's in can do. Knows how it makes out hard as it hits. That's the love Sekiha Tenkyoken. There, missiles. That's the follow-up attack we followed up with a couple missiles.
Boom.
Yeah.
Boom.
And 591 damage. Yeah. Nothing.
Oh, man.
This is nothing. Russell's stats are not built for doing damage in the first place. So, yeah, it's weird. This is another mech I really love, the Astaline.
We don't see much.
Look how fucking good these animations are. This is a Game Boy Advance game. Like, look how good these animations are. How much fucking... You know, how many frames of animation there are, how smooth it is, how fast it is. And you see, you know, video tricks like how it was deforming his sprite when the gravity, when the graviton cannon hit, or the way it was spinning her jet. Like, oh god. People say the GBA, like, people have been knocking on the GBA for so long. Like, no, this was actually, if you used it right, like most consoles, if you use them fucking right and actually build the game from the ground up for it, it does great. That's really so low ultimate attack. Rockstar rifle. That was used to be the ultimate attack of her mech. Before her mech became the Ryan Weissrider, back when it was just the Weissrider. Her ultimate attack was the Rockstar rifle. The animation was different, but. But then it got transformed into this, and so now her solo ultimate attack is the Howling Rifle X. Okay. Here, let's watch hers. Valor. Oh, do I even need to strike? Yeah, might as well. Oh, here. We'll just watch Howling Rifle X as well. And we get to see Phantom Phoenix. In case you didn't get enough Phoenix action from a Cash Buster. She actually just straight up fires a Phoenix at the enemy.
Jesus Christ.
Wow! Fucking love it.
That was cool.
Hey, we can finally see his health numbers.
99,999.
I should note that means that is where the 100,000 health mark was on the bar, so consider how big his health mark is. That's why I have to estimate their health. I think he's a 600,000 health guy. No, wait, this is X mode.
Feeling the headache from that?
Curious.
So about that much. 1, 2, 3.
Okay, so about 500,000 health probably. Maybe a bit more than that because, you know.
Right. Guesstimation of finger measurements is...
It's not a perfect science is what I'm trying to say here. Damn it, Russell.
So weak that you don't help.
Oh no, he's like he's not a good attacker, but oh boy, is he support to end all support throughout all of OG1, or most of OG1, like up until the last 5 stages, he was a higher level than every other character because you gain experience performing support.
Okay.
It's one of the best things the game, an RPG can do, is having support actions also get you XP. So if you perform heals or replenishment, they get XP for it. And he performed that job so much that he was a higher level than everyone until the last, like, 5 stages.
Huh.
When all the attackers finally started killing bosses and shit and jumping up. And even in this game, he's still... I don't think he's ever been, like, the highest level character, but he's always in the top upper echelons of my character level. Yeah. So, like, he's in the first page of 3 of my characters for character level. My man Kai being level 57, however, should come as no fucking shock. He is so good. He is my favorite, though. I can't even really risk using him twice, because of course he'll get hit. Granted, he's a huge tanky mech. Like, you'll notice that he actually has over 10,000 health.
Yeah.
None of my other units do. Yeah, fuck it. Let's use guard so he takes 1/3 the damage. This is it, the Caramel of the Century! Territory kicked in. Oh my god, is he gonna say it? 0 damage. If he says useless, 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 0 damage.
Damn, that's awesome.
That's what casting guard got me. It reduced the damage that he was capable of doing so much. G territory negates anything that does less than 2,000 or less damage. So the guard got it down to lower than 2,000 damage, and G territory kicked in and just completely nullified the attack. That's awesome.
Damn.
I haven't even thrown Rampage Ghosts or fucking Tornado Blades at him. I haven't even thrown another set of Twin Bird Strikes at him. The only combo attack I've used this turn is fucking Royal Heartbreaker. I've just been throwing everyone else at him for funsies because I wanted to watch more battle animations.
Half of your death.
Seriously. Oh man. This will have been the first time I've used OG1 and OG2 legitimately. Feels fucking good, man. And hell, I'm arguably doing this better than when I was cheating at the games in the past. Because I just understand, like, combat strategy and what skills are good and shit. Like, so much better than I used to. Like, on cheated data before, I had characters with infinite energy, infinite power, or SP and stuff. Just every turn. I was using nothing but combination attacks from everybody, never ran out of energy, never ran out of pilot, SP, so I could keep casting Valors and Alerts and Strikes over and over and over and over again. And I'm gonna kill him, like, in less time spent now, legitimately. Why? Because I didn't stop to get rid of the energy. So I was trying to do everything through his warp field. And that was with, like, an infinite money cheat, so everyone's, you know, everything was moneyed up to the max. And I'm doing better playing legit.
This is just going to take you one more attack to kill him. Can what's his name just kick him dead?
Oh, I already used him.
Oh, okay. So.
She doesn't have another use anymore.
Oh, yeah.
Who do I want to give the kill to? Gonna do it. Okay, notice the music just changed. That pilot's private music track is glitched. In situations where it's not supposed to play, like in the stage, only the boss's music is supposed to play during combat. So normally everybody's personal music will play when their combat starts on your side. But bosses' music always take priority. Nope. This guy's music is glitched and takes priority over everybody.
Just Sanger?
Not Sanger, Rats together.
Okay.
We fucking did it! Oh, man.
Damn.
Oh, that's not even...
2,000 money?
Yeah, imagine if I'd used the double money spell.
Yeah.
And the double XP spell.